Oh man, a little bit of Ed McMahon there. Yes, indeed. Does anybody know who the hell Ed McMahon is anymore? Just sit on the couch and laugh. Not Vince McMahon, Ed McMahon. Why am I making this video? Hang on here, excuse me. Why am I making this video? Well, is it because of this? First edition, Legend of Blue Eyes White Dragon, Dark Magician, in super gem mint condition. Look at that. That is the OG Dark Magician. The ultimate wizard in terms of attack and defense. Certainly not true, but good God, there he is. I always liked how the Dark Magician kind of had like a bluish green skin tone in the card game. In the anime, he was always white. Well, I don't know. Is he supposed to be Asian? I don't know. I can't tell in animes. Maybe he's supposed to be Asian. I don't have a fucking clue. But unless they're like specifically say they're Asian, I just assume they're white. I don't know. I know that's probably racist. I'm sure someone's going to get my ass about it. I don't really give a damn. But the point is that I used to think all the Dragon Ball characters were supposed to be white. I don't know. I know in Yu-Gi-Oh! Joey, for instance, is white. Joey, Pegasus, Bandit Keith. There's a few white characters in there, which is actually, I heard, was a record amount for an anime that takes place mostly in Japan. So anyways, I'm actually here for this. Breaker of Shadows, first edition booster box. I've been doing Dark Illusion. I figured I'd go back a little bit. This is released, I think, in January 2015. Or 2016, my bad. 2016. By the way, today is August 25th, 2016. So I got this. Just thought I'd go back a little bit, about 9 months, I guess. And good cards I want to get out of this. Naturally, I want to get best card is Solemn Strike, and then Cyber Dragon Infinity be sick. There's a few other cards. Twin Twisters is always good. Or a foil card in every pack. It was the first core booster set they had, where it did that. High Speed Riders was the first one, but that's not a core set. That's kind of like an extra set. So, yeah, let's get in this. Twin Twisters is the last super rare I think they'll ever be worth anything, unless something goes crazy and it turns out that there's a super rare printed someday where it's like you just win the game and you play it, that they accidentally made that way. You know, something like Vandy's Emptiness. Remember Vandy's Emptiness, common out of Star Strike Blast, I believe it was? Eventually got up to $40. Holy shit, I remember those days. Yeah. And then they printed the secret one out of Legendary Collection 5, was it? Yeah, Legendary Collection 5. And people were like, oh, the price will go down. Well, guess what? That Vanny's Emptiness was the chaser card. There's like one per case. And so instead, it kept the $40 price tag at the common, and then the secret became like a $50, $60 card. I can't get the box open right. There we go. It was insane. I was like, what the hell's going on here? All right. Here we go. Hoping to get Solemn Strike or Cyber Dragon Infinity. Those are the two cards that I'd really love to get. So, Pendulum Reborn and Shirinui Shogun Saga. An ultra rare to start the video. That's always a good one. Shogun Saga. Shirinui, of course, got their Shirinui Solitaire. And, I didn't realize they were that new. I mean, old. Shirinui Saga is already in Shogun Saga's Breaker of Shadow, huh? Twilight Ninja Gadetsu and Red Eyes Retro Dragon. This did come out in pretty sure Bosch Breaker of Shadow had songs. It's been so long. I might be wrong. I better not be thinking of Shining Victories. I'm pretty sure I'm not. Yeah, I'm not. Timebreaker Magician and Dynamis Rex. Dynamis, an archetype that if it got better cards would be a good archetype. Because all their cards are pretty shitty, but there's a couple of bright spots in them. Dynamis Rex is one of them. Dynamis Plesiosaur is one of them. Petoran's not bad. I mean, they're an okay. Like, if you need a cheap deck, they're the ones to go with. Performable Gaturtle and Gaiden Ariadne, which has made a comeback thanks to Metal Foes. It's now kind of a staple in Metal Foes. Because you get to destroy it, get a good ass counter trap card out of your hand. That's multiple times per turn. You can do it as many times as you want. It's kind of bullshit. Alright. Jizukuri, the Star Destroyer Kaiju, and Trap Tricks Raffle Sage. I'll take it. That's a good and a secret rare there. I forgot this was in here too. But yeah, that's a good monster to get. Appreciate it. That's actually a horrible monster to stare down sometimes. I hate. Just banned. I forgot the ban list came out yesterday. Monkey Board's banned now. Hell yeah. What else got banned? Kaiser Coliseum. I guess Metal Foes is the reason. I couldn't figure it out, but someone told me that Metal Foes got something coming up in Invasion of Venom, or Venom Vengeance, as they call it over here in TCG, is going to have some Trump Girl. Look, Donald Trump Girl, General Coral, Reject Reborn, and Buster Whelp. I get so many Buster Whelps. I'm pretty sure in other videos I've complained about it. I just get Buster Whelps up the ass. Seems like every super rare. I think I opened like 6 packs and 4 out of 6 had Buster Whelp in it. I think Buster Blader just got support in Dark Illusion. Maybe it's next set? I don't remember. I know the next set's crazy. Invasion of Venom. There's so many old archetypes getting support, like aliens. Oddeye's Advent and Quaking Mirror Force. That's a good altar to get. That's actually probably one of the better altars I can think of right now to get. I like it. They messed up, though. It's an altar, not a secret. Think about it. Storming Mirror Force, Blazing Mirror Force, and Drowning Mirror Force are all secrets, but Quaking for the reason is an ultra. That was a mistake. They should have looked forward into that. And what's weird is that was the third Mirror Force of the made Mirror Force an archetype. And they're done with it because they've used every attribute. Even though they should make a new one for the light and dark ones. Alright, Goyu King and Twin Twisters. There we go. I figured I'd get one. There's the Twin Twisters. One of it's got a little misprint dot on it. Whatever. The card to get for super rare. It's like, almost everyone's running Twin Twisters, it seems like. I get nailed by it all the time. I use it. In most of my decks. This is hella good. Just a good-ass card. Especially for, Burning Abyss or even Blue Eyes. I love using my Blue Eyes. Discard something and revive it or gets an effect. Petran and Interrupted Kaiju Slumber. Man, it looks like a lot of these cards are getting little dots on them. You see that dot right there? A lot of Dino Mist. I can't believe Super Heavy Samurai is still getting support. Like, every set, they get a card. Robot Buster Destruction Sword? I don't remember being a robot. And see, there's Dragon Buster, and there's Robot Buster. Huh. What we got here? Gardarla, the Mystery Dust Kaiju, Mothra, and Tuning Magician. Yeah, good old Mothra. Mothra had its own movie before it went into Godzilla. I haven't watched it in a long time. I actually own that movie. A little while, I got an old Godzilla movie and I was buying them whenever I found them. And I found the old Mothra and it was on one of those weird things where it's like one DVD, like 6 movies or something. God, I can't open this pack. But I was like, whoa, okay, I was got Mothra and then like a whole bunch of shit movies with it. It's like the only one that mattered was Mothra and it was pretty expensive, like $15. And I'm like, well, I guess that's the price for Mothra. Fiendish Rhino Warrior and Mage Spectre Supercell. Fiendish Rhino Warrior just became a super rare in OTS Pack 2. Burning Abyss got hit. Beatrice down to 1. And Sir also down to 1 to join his buddy Graf. Man, these packs don't want to open. Come on now. There we go. Steel Cavalry Denin and Chimera Tech Rampage Dragon. Cyber Dragon support. Draco Faceoff is at 1 still, which is good. I can't believe it was at 3 at one point. I mean, Pepe was so good a little bit. Like, I couldn't beat it at all. All right, left side of the box. Let's see what we can get. Finish right word, Enlightenment Paladin. The cover monster, right there. That is the cover monster, Enlightenment Paladin, which I've never seen one use. All right. Following, there's Plesios. Shinry Spirit Master and Dharma Eye Magician. I think I got Tuning Magician as well. Is there another magician monster in here that's a pendulum? Did I get them all? Is there only two? I don't remember. Oh, man, these packs are just incredibly tough. You got a Reject Reborn and another Twin Twisters. Nice! Two in one box is what I'm talking about. Hell yeah. Discard one card, destroy two spell or trap cards on the field. Hell yeah. It always sucks when you top deck that with nothing in hand. It's like, well, you gotta kind of plan around it too. Like, set it and just hope that you don't die and then you can draw into something. Nah. Alright. Arisen, the guy of Fearless Night, and Interrupted Kaiju Slumber. Getting doubles with supers. Already got a Kaiju Slumber. Blackwing Harmattan the Dust. For whatever reason I said dust, I thought of Sandstorm by Darude. I heard that song randomly, like earlier this week, and I was like, no, not Darude. Samurai, High Speedroid Hikotoga, and Buster Blader, this Dragon Destroyer Swordsman. This is a secret rare I've gotten like six times. I always get this guy, but you know what? I really like his artwork. I think he's a pretty sick looking monster. I mean, look how cool he is. He can't attack directly, but, and then inflicts piercing damage in every dragon type monster on the field, or in either player's graveyard, I think it is, something like that. Gains 1,000 attack, let me make sure here. Yeah, every dragon type monster your opponent controls are in their graveyard. I lost to a Buster Blader deck once, actually, when Breaker Shadows first came out. Well, it didn't help that I just drew into horrible, horrible cards. With my Cosmo just betrayed me, but the guy played really well. I'll never forget that defeat. High speed re-level Tune Buster Blader and another Tuning Magician. Got one of those weird effects where you lose 400 life points, your opponent gains 400. Your opponent gains 400, then you take 400. Morholga Turtle and Odd Eyes Gravity Dragon. The most worthless Odd Eyes Dragon card in the game. Like, nobody uses Odd Eyes Gravity Dragon. Like, what a horrible ultra to get. But I like my secrets. Secrets are good so far, and they aren't Solemn Strike or Cyber Dragon Infinity, but I'll take them. Dynaster Power, the Mighty Dracoslayer, and Gaia Nerydin. Man, I'm getting a lot of the same supers. Maybe there's not that many different supers in this set. It was the first one they did this with. Alright, still moving on here. Goyo King and Cosmo Sword Troopers. Some people really like Sword Troopers. I'm not a big fan. I mean, it might be better now that Dark Destroyer got limited and E-Telic went back to one. What a life story for E-Telic. He's at one for years and goes to three and now it's back to one. Right back where you started, E-Telic. Mercy Teleport, of course. Alright, I think I got three packs left, including this one. Look at all these dino cards in a row. Goyo Defender and Mage Spectre Superspell. Supercell, my bad. Supercell, like perfect cell? Semi-perfect cell? Sucking up androids. Getting killed by Gohan. Gohan Chan. Mage Spectre Sonics. Super Heavy Samurai Beast Kyuubi. And Buster Whelp. There it is. I had to get a second Buster Whelp. I mean, come on. I thought for a second I was only going to get one. But there it is. That's Buster Whelp number two. Is there Buster Whelp number three in the last pack? The final pack? Oh, my God. These last packs. All right. Here we go. Dynamis Patan and Mage Spectre Toto Gamma. Forgot that he was in this set. I was like, I was looking at that, I'm like, is he in this set? I think so. Banned. Monkey board banned now. All right, so let's take a look at what I got. Let's see here. So, my ultras and stuff. I got Odd-Eye's Gravity Dragon. Got a Secret Buster Blader, the Dragon Destroyer Swordsman. Twin Twisters, that's basically an ultra. Lightman Paladin. Another Twin Twisters. Quaking Mirror Force, that's a good one. Traptrix, Raflasia. Did I only get three ultras? No, there's another one. Shiranui Saga, Sogun Saga. I did get four. Well, I enjoyed that. I had an Open Breaker show in quite a while. Glad to get the Buster Blader. I mean, that's like my spirit monster, or whatever the hell they say on the internet now for this set. I always get that guy. I mean, like, always. It's incredible. And shout-outs to the Twin Twisters. Such a good card. Last great super in terms of value. $10. And, of course, Quaking Mirror Force. I have no idea if people still want these or not, but, you know, good. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I certainly did. I always enjoy opening up packs. And I will catch you next time. I'm getting drunk all the time. Hope you all are, too. And always remember to drink responsibly. That's a good one. All right, guys. I'll see you later. Peace!